The next topic is bond parameters. Here bond parameters, and in this bond parameter the first one is bond length. Here bond length means it is called as the interatomic distance also. The distance between two bonded atoms is simply called as bond length. Here bond length is equal to radius of A plus radius of B. If A and B having same electronegativity, or if the electronegativity value difference is zero, then we can directly go for this formula. If electronegativity difference between two atoms is not equal to zero, then bond length is equal to RA plus RB minus 0.09 into XA minus XB. This is the formula given by Shoemaker and Stevenson, and this is calculating bond length for electronegativity difference containing if the two atoms are having zero electronegativity, not equal to zero electronegativity. So the difference is not equal to zero. If they have difference in the electronegativity, then we use this formula to calculate the bond length. Bond length is measured in angstrom minutes, nanometers and centimeters. And here, bond length depending factors. So, bond length influencing factors. Factors affecting bond length. So, bond length affecting factors if we are taking. In this first factor is electronegativity difference. So what is the electronegativity difference? Suppose if bond length and electronegativity difference is taken, they are inversely proportional. Suppose I am taking HF and suppose I am taking HCl and I am taking HBr and I am taking HF. In this H and F, electronegativity difference is more. Whenever electronegativity difference is more, bond length is less. And HI, hydrogen and iodine, electronegativity value difference is less. So bond length is, so difference is less means bond length, electronegativity difference is less, then bond length is more. So here the bond length order I am taking. This is the bond length order. Bond length order, HF is having less bond length, whereas HI is having more bond length, because HI has less electronegativity difference. That is first point. And next, second point is bond order. Bond order, or it is also called as a number of bonds. Here, bond length is inversely proportional to bond order or number of bonds. Please remember, bond order is nothing but number of bonds. Here suppose if you are taking how this is related. C single bond C, C double bond C, C triple bond C. Here C single bond C bond length is 1.54 angstrom minutes. And C double bond C bond length is 1.34 angstrom minutes. And this is 1.20 angstrom minutes. It is clearly indicating that whenever the number of bonds increases, means bond order increases, the bond length value decreases. That is a second factor, that is bond length. And third factor, here percentage of S character. Percentage of S character. Here bond length is inversely proportional to percentage of S character. The percentage of S character. How? Suppose if there is a single bond and hydrogen, means this is sp3 carbon atom, and next single bond and hydrogen, it is not single bond, double bond, and this is sp2 carbon atom, and there is a triple bond and hydrogen. Here it is sp carbon atom. Then here sp3 carbon hydrogen bond is 1.09 angstrom minutes, and this is 1.08 angstrom minutes, and this is 1.06 angstrom units. You can say simply, what is the percentage of S? In sp3, percentage of S is S percentage is 25. Here 25% S, and here it is 33.3% S, and here it is 50% S. So when sp hybridization is there, 50% S character is present. So what happened when S percentage is increasing? Bond length decreased. So percentage of S character and bond length are inversely proportional. And the fourth and important point, the resonance and hyperconjugation also we can use. Hyperconjugation and resonance. This resonance and hyperconjugation we studied in organic chemistry also. Here resonance and hyperconjugation. For example, simple I am taking double bond, double bond, double bond. Here generally C single bond, C bond length is 1.54 angstrom units. C double bond, C bond length is 1.34 angstrom units. It is 1.34 angstrom units. But in the benzene, this is called as benzene. In benzene, the C-C bond length is 1.39 angstrom units, which is in between C single bond C and C double bond C. How we can say, so this is what is happening here? These double bond and single bonds are not constantly, or it is not fixed. They are continuously moving around the carbon atoms. So in this carbon atom, so by the resonance, what is the next structure we are getting? Yes, this double bond, double bond, double bond. Means double bond positions are changing continuously. The delocalization of pi bonds is called as simply resonance. Because of resonance, what happens means bond length affected. Okay, this is about bond length. The next bond parameter is bond energies. Here the bond energies, it is called as the amount of energy required to break a bond. To break a single covalent bond is called as bond energy, or it is also called as bond formation energy. When a bond is formed, the amount of energy released is also called as bond formation energy or bond dissociation energy. Both are same, approximately both are same for any type of molecules. And bond energy influencing factors. The factors which influences bond energy, if you are taking, the first one is bond order. Whenever bond order is taken, bond energy is directly proportional to number of bonds or bond order. Bond energy is directly proportional to bond order. C single bond C, C double bond C, C triple bond C. Here number of bonds increases, bond energy also increases. And second factor is lone pairs. Here lone pairs, and we are taking, bond energy is inversely proportional to number of lone pairs. Suppose if you are taking carbon carbon, is there any lone pair? No. Next one is nitrogen. Here nitrogen nitrogen, one lone pair is present. The next one is oxygen oxygen. Here one lone pair, two lone pair. Here oxygen, one lone pair, two lone pair. And if fluorine is taken, three lone pairs are present. 1, 2, 3. And fluorine, 1, 2, 3. Whenever the number of lone pairs increases, bond energy's values decreases. This is bond energy's order. Lone pairs are increasing, but bond energy decreases. So bond energy is inversely proportional to lone pairs. And next point is third point, bond polarity. Bond polarity, or this also we can take electronegativity difference. Here HF and HCl suppose, and here HBr and here HF. In this HF is having more bond energy than Cl, Br and I. Because bond polarity, bond energy is directly proportional to electronegativity difference or bond polarity. Whenever HF is taken, fluorine hydrogen bond is stronger because electronegativity difference is more. Then it can attract the bond to electron strongly. So the bond cannot be broken easily and HI easily dissociate. Okay, that is bond polarity. And next, S character. Fourth point is percentage of S character. So percentage of S character if you are taking. Here, in the percentage of S character, SP, SP hybrid and SP2, SP2 hybrid and SP3, SP3 hybrid. Generally, SP, SP means more S character, then that is having more bond energy. So, SP character containing like similar here, he said now here this is SP3, SP3, here this is SP, SP. Same point we can say, here SP, SP means C double bond, here C double bond, here C single bond. C single bond, C. Okay, that is a percentage of S character. When bond energy is taken, bond energy is directly proportional to percentage of S character. Percentage of S character. Okay, that is bond energy relation. Even resonance also affects bond energy. Suppose if resonance is present, sometimes because of resonance energy, bond energy values increases. Due to resonance, bond energy values increases. So resonance also influences the bond energy values between atoms. And so these are the factors which influences bond energy. The third bond parameter is bond angle. It is simply called as angle between two bonded pair of electrons or two bonded atoms. And here bond angle influencing factors. The factors which influences bond angle. Bond angle is directly proportional to S character. It is directly proportional to S character. Because suppose if you are taking SP, SP2, SP3. Here SP means 50% S character, it is 33.33% S character and this is 25% S character. Generally SP hybridization means what is the bond angle? 180 degrees. Here it is 120 degrees, it is 109 degrees 28 minutes. So whenever S character is more, bond angle is more. That is first point. Second point, bond angle is inversely proportional to number of lone pairs. Number of lone pairs. Whenever we are taking the number of lone pairs. Here, this number of lone pairs is taken with same central atom or same hybridization. With same central atom hybridization. Suppose hybridization is same. When hybridization is same. For example, if you are taking CH4 and if you are taking NH3, if you are taking H2, here CH4, what is the hybridization? SP3. Here also hybridization is SP3. Here also hybridization is SP3. But in this SP3, what is the bond angle? 109 degrees, 28 minutes. Here NH3 having a lone pair and here the bond angle is 107 degrees. Here H2O has two lone pairs. The bond angle is 104.5 degrees. Here lone pairs number 0. Here lone pair 1. Here lone pair is 2. Means number of lone pairs increases, bond angle is decreasing. So that is bond angle and number of lone pairs relation. And next, last point, bond angle, third point, bond angle is directly proportional to electronegativity of central atom. Central atom. Here, I am taking two examples, H2O and H2S. Here, H2O molecule is having 104.5 degrees. whereas H2S is having 92 degrees nearly. Why the H2O has more bond angle means the lone pair and bond pair repulsions and bond pair repulsions when we are taking, here bond pair repulsions are more because they are closer to the central atom. Whereas in the sulfur, lone pair repulsions present, but bond pair are not much closer to the central atom. Whenever they are not much closer, the repulsion between the bond pair is less. Okay, so whenever the repulsions are more, they have more angle. So whenever bond angle and electron activity of central atom is taken, they are directly proportional. This is about different bond parameters.